Hello, my name is Patrick Kelleher. I'm a product manager at Microsoft, and today I'm going to talk to you about news and show you all the new features we've been working on that'll help you communicate effectively at your company. Today, I'm going to talk to you about news distribution. This is taking news and having it meet your employees or your users wherever they are, be it Outlook, Microsoft Teams, Yammer, or SharePoint, even Office.com. Taking news that's important and being able to promote it across different surfaces. For news that's very important, being able to take it and boost it to amplify it and stop this piece of news being buried. And finally, understanding news. Getting your message out to employees is important. Understanding how your employees engage with your content is equally critical. News page analytics help you understand consumption and engagement with your news content. You can generate metrics for reach and engagement, like dwell time, and see the number of viewers who have read content. First, let's look at office.com. I've signed in here using Megan's AAD account. By using Megan's organizational account, this means that she'll be automatically logged into corporate websites. Here Megan can see the items that are recommended for her. If I go across, I can see that Megan has news articles that are now showing up. Megan can click any of these items, which will take her directly to the news item. News is, of course, available on SharePoint Home. News shows up front and center on SharePoint Start Pages. This is a way that you can show off news in your company in a very beautiful manner. And you might have noticed on the left-hand side, we have a new app bar. And of course, you'll be able to see the news icon on the app bar on the left-hand side. Clicking into this shows the latest news. Clicking on any of these news items will take you straight to that item. Finally, we're going to look at something that's a daily habit for most users. Opening up Outlook is something I generally do first thing in the morning. You can already send manual email digests to the users in your company. We've heard from employees that keeping up with so much news information can be challenging. So to make things easier, we've come up with a new feature called Auto News Digest. This will send a summary of key news to users of news they have not read yet. One thing that's really nice about this is that it only shows news articles that Megan has not yet read here. So here we can see some stats about the news items, why they're recommended for Megan, and Megan can click on these to open them directly. This email gets sent out once a week, and it only shows news items that Megan has not already read. So if a news item shows up inside of this email, it means that Megan hasn't read it yet. This is because we don't want to overwhelm users with news, with redundant news that they've already seen. One other thing you'll notice about this email is that it's branded with Contoso Electronics. We've listened to your feedback that branding is really important, so it's not going to look like this email comes from SharePoint. It's going to be branded with your company's logo and colors that you use directly from your SharePoint start page. So you'll maintain control and branding of the email. And now, for the first time, SharePoint News shows up right inside of my favorite browser, Microsoft Edge. News shows up beautifully. You can easily get your message out to all users at your company. And users can feel confident that they're up to date with the latest news at your company. While Auto News Digest is a great way of getting news out to users in your company for messages that they hadn't seen, if you want to explicitly send news items to users, here's some new ways that you can do that. So I'm here logged in as Megan on the Contoso News site. There's a really important piece of news that I want to share out with my team. There's a really important update that I want to send out to my team, the Singapore building update. I'm going to open up the news item. Now that I have the news post, I want to send it to my team. But instead of sending email, my team tends to use Yammer a lot. This is a great way as well to stoke up social engagement on news posts. I'm going to select Share to Yammer. From here, you'll see that there's a beautiful preview of the news post. I'm going to share out a message. Instead of a message, I think I'm going to take advantage of some of Yammer's capabilities. I can ask a question, I can select praise, or I can do a poll. Here I want to ask my team, what are they most looking forward to in the Singapore building update? The rooftop garden is going to be super cool. There's going to be bikes available to bring across campus. And of course, meeting rooms are going to have Teams integration built right in. So I'm going to select my community. I'm going to send this to the entire company. Now I can see my news post show up right there inside of Yammer, complete with the poll. Of course, I'm really looking forward to meeting rooms with Teams integration. Who doesn't love being able to just walk into a conference room and have your meeting there ready to rock? As communicators, you've told us that not all announcements and news are equal. Sometimes you need to boost critical information to the top of an employee's feed. To address this, we've created a new feature for news called Boost. News Boost works on organizational sites, and you can use it to boost any news post. You can take a news post and you can elevate it to the top of a feed and set specific criteria that's personalized on a per-user basis. Let's take this news post. Miriam Graham has recently joined as Contoso's Chief Marketing Officer. Let's jump on in to find out about Miriam. Here we can find out all about Miriam. When I look at the page, I'm a little bit discouraged to see that it only has 10 views. I want to make sure that everybody in the company learns about Miriam Graham by coming to this news post. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take advantage of this new feature and I'm going to boost this news post. To boost the news post, I click Boost. Once I've turned Boost on, I see the options for the boost duration. This configures how long users will see this inside of their feed. For the first option, this means that it'll show up for all users until they read the news post. For the next option, a specified number of news impressions, you can select how many times do you want this show up at the top or show up prominently in a user's feed. This is configurable from 1 all the way up to 20 impressions. And finally, if it's a time-sensitive announcement or if it's time-contextual, so a good example here might be like a virtual 5K race, or some piece of news which is only relevant for a short time period, you can select for a specified time frame. So given that Miriam is new, I expect that everybody is going to know about Miriam within the next 2 weeks. So I'm going to select to boost this item until the middle of October. Underneath here, you'll also see the ranking of the item. I can rank it relative to other items that are boosted. Because this is so important, I'm going to move Miriam's news post all the way to the top. By doing this, this means that it'll take precedence over other boosted items. Once I have boosted my item, it'll show up prominently in anywhere news is shown. The first surface that we've enabled is the Auto News Digest. Let's jump into Megan's email and take a look. Here we are in Megan's Outlook account, and if we open up the news digest, we'll see the news that Megan has yet to catch up on. Up the very top, you'll see that there's a boosted news story. This is a story that Megan has not yet read, and because it's boosted, it shows up at the top of Megan's newsfeed. You might be wondering why Miriam's article isn't up there. That's because Megan has already read it. Only content that has not yet been read shows up in the auto news digest. And likewise, if Megan has already seen a piece of content that has been boosted, then it'll be no longer boosted for her. Now let's jump on over to Edge and see what that looks like when signed in as Megan. Here we are, signed in to Edge on Megan's account. And if we scroll down, we'll see SharePoint News show up. This is a great way for Megan to see what's top of mind in the organization. And also you notice that the top two news articles here have been boosted. This way, content curators can feel confident that any boosted news shows up at the top of news feeds. And Megan knows that when she sees news, that she's going to be well informed of what's going on at the company. As a content creator, I really want to know how my content is performing. When I create news posts, I want to understand how well they're doing, what's the reach of them, are people liking, are they engaging with them, are they putting comments on them? It's really important for me to know that my message is heard everywhere, and that when I create a news post, that users actually can, one, discover it, two, read through it, and then finally engage with it and provide feedback. You might have already seen some of the file card analytics that you can access through site pages, but now we're bringing some insights right to the page themselves. So today I'm proud to announce that we have page analytics on SharePoint. About 60% of content creators don't measure their content or how it's performing. Don't be in that bucket. Know how your content is doing so you'd be confident to know that, yes, it actually is making a difference. So now that we've looked at some of the site analytics, you're probably wondering, how can I understand how pages are performing, how individual news posts are doing, what's their readership, how many people are they reaching? Over 60% of communicators don't measure how their content is performing. Don't be in that bucket. Today I'm proud to announce Page Analytics for SharePoint. You can take any SharePoint page or news post and find out exactly how it's performing. Here we can see how the SharePoint homepage is performing. We have page viewers, page visits, dwell time, and page traffic by time. So let's take a look at these. So for page viewers, this is the number of unique visitors to your page. We can see here in the last week, there have been 9 viewers of this page, and the lifetime number of viewers is 10. Page visits is the number of time this page has been loaded by your users. The lifetime value here is 891 visits to the page. Next, we have dwell time. That is the amount of time that users are spending on the page. Here we can see that users are spending a lot of time on this page, an hour and a half per user. And finally, we have page traffic by time. This shows what time of the day users are landing on this page. And we can look over time and see patterns emerging and what times users are landing on the page and consuming information. This really helps us determine when users are landing on the page and when we should schedule news posts to be published. This feature will be available before the end of the year, and we're also adding additional charts to bring it up to the same standards as what we have on site usage today. So there'll be platform usage and the ability to export data for all page analytics. So that's a great first look at page analytics. Now, beyond page analytics, we're also going to create a page analytics digest. So if you create a piece of content, a SharePoint page or a news post, a week after you publish it, we're going to send you an analytics digest which highlights how your content is performing and also providing you with nudges for things you can do, such as share it, promote it, or boost if it's content on an organizational news site to extend the reach of the content. Now, one thing we haven't talked about is about the length of the content itself. When you're creating a post, how long should it be, and what's the optimum amount of time? Well, we can't tell you exactly how long the post should be, but what we can do is tell you how long will it take people to read that news post, And not only can we do it afterwards, we can do it in real time while you're typing it out. Check this out. Here, Megan is writing a news post on behalf of Paddy, the president of the company. We can see that this article is nearly 10 minutes to read. And if we paste an additional text, we can actually see this being updated in real time. Now, 10 minutes is quite a long read for a weekly status update. So let's take out this section down below and see how it impacts the article. This is much better. Megan now is confident that Paddy's news post will be read thoroughly. We hope this feature will be useful for you so you can understand how long it'll take a piece of content to be read. This concludes my presentation for today. All of the features that I showed will be available by the end of 2020. The places where Boost shows up will be completed by next year at the Microsoft 365 conference. So let's look at a quick summary of what we talked about today. So just to quickly recap, we talked about news distribution, having news show up everywhere. So it's on office.com. On office.com, on Edge, going to make it easier for your users to see news they haven't seen before using the Auto News Digest. Next up, for news that's super important, we're going to give you new abilities to promote it. Next, we're going to give you new ways to share news, so beyond email, so it's going to show up inside of Yammer and Teams. Next, when you want to boost news, we want to make sure that that there's ways of amplifying super important news for news that you don't want to be buried below the feed. You want to say, hey, this is super important. It's going to be personalized on a per user basis. That'll be showing up, and it'll be showing up first on the Auto News Digest and on Edge, on the new tab page on Edge. And throughout the year, throughout the coming months, we're going to have Boost show up on more surfaces. And finally, we talked a lot about news analytics and understanding your news reach. So that's the time to read, understanding how long it's going to take someone to actually consume a news post. It's also page analytics. So understanding, hey, how are pages performing beyond what's there already today to the file card. And finally, the analytics digest, where we'll be sent, where you'll receive a digest on your news post, and you can see how it's performing, along with helpful hints on action you can take to make it show up in more places. Thank you very much for listening to my talk today. And if you have any questions or suggestions of what we should work on next, please don't hesitate to reach out and ask. Thank you.